Ed Larry, EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Tonight, it's a preseason matchup between the Indianapolis Colts and the San Diego Chargers. Here comes Philip Dorsett now to return it. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Again, we'll see the pistol here. And a first carry here for Charles Sims. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
One of the things that really impressed me about Joey Bosa is that he doesn't sacrifice the run game trying to get sacks. This guy really knows how to hold the point of attack. Great leverage, and then goes and checks people and makes plays.
And at 6'5", 270, just a monster.
Absolute monster with a really high motor.
It'll be a gain of six, and that's going to lead to a third down.
And that's the kind of pass that adds up over time, Brandon. You may not have picked up a first down there, but if you keep chipping away at it, eventually big plays may result.
And on third and eight, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. Six defensive backs. Off of play action, Luck. Finding time, all kinds of time, and this is going to be incomplete. Philip Dorsett, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up fourth down. On fourth down, here's Pat McAfee to kick it away. This is taken at the 18. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. So here's the Charger offense making their way out. Leading them out is going to be their quarterback. That's the grizzled vet, Ryan Fitzpatrick.
One thing that I think Ryan Fitzpatrick doesn't get enough credit for is his toughness. This is a guy who plays through injuries, but it's also being mentally tough. Knowing that everyone's always trying to move him out of the lineup, trying to find a replacement for him, yet he continues to battle and has earned the total respect of his teammates.
What a spin. And he'll get this up to about the 40. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Now a second down throw for Fitzpatrick. He's going to look for Allen now on the deep ball. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. To throw is Fitzpatrick. Finds his target. It's Gates. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
Do you get the sense, Brandon, that people are trying to retire Antonio Gates? They keep thinking this is almost the end of the line, and then he keeps making catches like the one we just saw there.
He's the old reliable, you're right, just one of nine players in the NFL with 100 or more touchdowns. 2 yards on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Fitzpatrick now on second down. Going to throw right side here, complete. And he's brought down after a good game. Hard to imagine a quarterback like this would be available in a trade. I mean, what an impact he's going to have.
And you know exactly why they went out and got him. They want to win and win big, and he provides that opportunity for them.
Caught right side. It's Lewis. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. I still find it utterly unbelievable that this guy was unsigned heading into the year. Now here he is throwing passes for his new mates.
And my hat's off to their front office, you know, from the GM.
And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Chargers have taken a first quarter lead. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him. Let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. Returnable for Dorsett. And nice work on the return as he'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Colts now, their offense works their way back onto the field. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt, they're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
On second down, here's Locke. Philip Dorsett hauls it in. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
He's got time. And an alley to run. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll make it a second down. Three receivers to the left, one to the right. Here's Luck now on second down. And his throw is incomplete.
And they insert their dime package, six DBs here on third and six.
Expecting pass all the way. Throwing on third down, Luck. And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up fourth down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
And this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25, and it will. Right at the 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. Fitzpatrick on first down. Complete. This is Lewis. And he's brought down after a good game. Give him back now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's the Chargers here with a football. And they've got it here with a first down. First throw now for the backup Carr. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that'll make it second down. So this brings up a second and two.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. And he gets it down to the 32. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Now Carr, he'll buy some time right. And they went for a big play through the air on second down, couldn't connect. Now it's third. The offense staring at a third and 12 here.
When teams take shots at the end zone, you've got to defend it the same way you would defend the first down sticks. You defend the goal line exactly the same way. They can't cross that. You play through the receivers, and on that play, that's exactly what they did and batted it away.
So on is Matt Prater now to try a field goal here. He's going to need a little mustard on this one. It'll be a 51-yard attempt. And that one's not going to get there. Not enough juice, an ambitious effort, but it's well short. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
Now they'll run it on the toss. Trying to get out wide, but he's going to be tackled right near the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
A 1-yard gain could look like a disaster. It all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
2 yards to go here on third down.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position end up making the tackle, and oftentimes we call them a hybrid, combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop. I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two.
And now on the pitch, the ball's loose.
On plays like this, where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete.
I see an extra DB on the field now for San Diego.
Yeah, indeed. Now Tolzien. And that is incomplete. Here's Pat McAfee now, as he's on to punt for Indianapolis. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. And now San Diego getting set to go. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. Defense has set themselves up nicely. Third and 10 now.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it. But we always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Shows some confidence, supreme confidence.
Big time confidence that he would make the play for him, and he did.
It's a pickup of 16 there that'll lead to a new set of downs.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage, and that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
Carr to throw again. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call it the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Now Carr, and he dropped it. Now it was tipped, altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it, and now fourth down.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football, because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion, and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
It's a gain of 6 on the play, and now Indianapolis set to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
They'll throw now on the final play. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So we have reached halftime in our first preseason. Never mind, Larry, forget your halftime report. Apparently, we are set for the third quarter of action already. Returnable here for Davis. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. One receiver left, that's Allen.
We ready?
On first down, Carr. Caught, right side, it's Lewis. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Jarvis Jones that time, in on the stop. And the offense moving quickly to the line. To throw, it's Carr. Throws a quick hitter on the slant, that's complete. They give him 12 yards and a first down. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer. In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end of the half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game. And with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. Carr trying to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return just out across the 15 to the 16-yard line.
Naturally, we're going to say it was a poor pass, but the defensive guys say it was just a great play by them. They broke on the football, picked it off, and gave some momentum to their team.
Tolzien, he's got time in the pocket, and he's going to be brought down. Back at his own 6-yard line. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. If you get 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it...
And he's going to go down. He backed up into the end zone, and this is going to wind up a safety. So make it back-to-back sacks, and the second one cost him a couple of points.
And the easy thing is to put this all on the offensive line, but maybe they need to start changing their game planning and their calls. Quicker passes, running plays, especially when you're this deep in your own territory.
Now the free kick comes after the safety from the 20 as they bring the punter on to try and get some hang time here. This is taken at the 23. One receiver left, that's Allen. They go back to the air here after the INT. And his throw here is incomplete. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's 2nd and 10. Now Carr, penalty marker is down here. Survey, pressure from his right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back. That's one of those ones that is so hard to judge, but defensive holding there, that's what the referee saw. On 1st and 10, here's Carr. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down. Here's Vereen. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. And all the way in. Touchdown, San Diego. And the Chargers find a way to stretch their lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
And unable to connect. They don't get the two-point conversion here. The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Here on first down, finding time, still back there, and complete to Lewis over the middle, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Still first down.
As they run the counter play. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. Give him 8 on the gain there. And it's good enough for an Indianapolis first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy. Let him pick up the first down.
Now Tolzien to the sideline. And oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tap and foot dragging, picking it up and making sure it was a catch.
And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And we're back now in Mission Valley and San Diego. It's the Colts, so they've got the football, but they've got work to do, trailing here as we begin the fourth quarter. They'll look to throw here on first down. His throw incomplete. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. They come out 5 wide. 3 of them to the right side.
Green, 39.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. And that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down.
What a game this defense has played. They're pitching a shutout, so it'll be fun to watch down the stretch to see if their defensive coordinator continues to be as aggressive as he's been all game long.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
And I know it's hard in live action, but you've got to keep your hands away from the face. That's a 15-yard penalty.
You work on it all the time, making sure your target area is lower and trying to keep your hands away from the face mask so you don't get the big penalty.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Their big-bodied receiver, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Colts are able to cut into this lead. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route ordinarily is probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. Throwing on first down is Carr. Now look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
He's got time. And he's got it. The conversion good, and we are tied in the fourth. Still time to work with on the clock, but they wanted to tie now, and they got it.
And I love their aggressiveness. Go ahead and get it done. Get the game tied. Now your team has the momentum, and you're staring across the field saying, let's see if you can match us.
And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. Now Carr to try again after the pick six. Flush to his right. And some space here. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. That one goes for 24 yards.
Now those are the ones that hurt defensively. You do everything right. Excellent pressure, good coverage downfield, and then he slips out the back door and turns it into a nice gain.
And his throw's going to be incomplete. So the incomplete pass brings up second down.
We're ready.
Carr now to throw. And his throw is incomplete.
I wouldn't be shocked at all right now if there's a look of surprise on the big fella's face because he had the route that he wanted, running the corner. And usually he's able to use his body and catch the football. But a really nice play by the defenders, able to knock it away.
And incomplete here on third down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. And here's a fair catch taken at about the 24-yard line. Well, pretty woeful there, just 23 yards on the punt. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10.
Here we go. 3-19.
And on the ground they go with a running back. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. Hitting the home stretch here in a great game, a tie game. Let's see if the defense can get the stop they need to get the ball back. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll get this one up to the 26. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to 3rd down. And this will probably be the final play before the 2-minute warning.
They know that old expression, it's not my night.
Let's go.
It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. He'll return it from the 6. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
A great return there of 22 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
All right, here we go.
To throw is Carr. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
All right, here we go.
Carr to throw. He's going to try and go deep again. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Here's Drew Kaser now, as he'll punt it away for the second time.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
And picked up by the Chargers.
I remember sitting in special teams meetings, and at some point during the meeting, the coach would always say, you better treat this one just like you're playing offense or defense. It's a big part of the game. And we just saw evidence of why right there with that fumble.
Yeah, fumble on the punt, and after it was turning up to be a pretty decent return.
Yeah, a really nice return. They were going to be set up okay, and the offense would feel good running onto the field. And now the defense has to try it out there and try and slow them down. I know that interception was dropped, and it would have been their third of the game. And I will guarantee you, in the huddle, on the bench, all the defensive guys have been talking about is, we've got this guy right where we want him. Who's going to get the next one? It almost becomes a check.
And now here's a timeout called by the Colts on the defensive side of the ball. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. On the run, here's Vereen. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. And another timeout taken by the Colts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Back to throw, Carr. And his pass incomplete.
All right, here we go.
Now Carr. And he comes back with one complete. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. So just about a minute to go here, tie ball game.
As fans, we love free football. But the guys in the field don't. They're going to attack and go for the win right now.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yes, now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
An extra DB defensively here. Big stop needed on third and goal.
He may be a blitzer.
They'll run here with Vereen. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Chargers. Shane Vereen with time running out. And the Chargers are going to take the lead.
Well, any thoughts about overtime have ended at this juncture. That touchdown puts them up 6. I would imagine they'll kick the extra point now and rely on their defense.
Yeah, rely on their defense. So a little bit of time left on the clock here in the fourth, but they got to feel good now. The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. And it's a short kick taken out beyond the 20. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. Will be incomplete.
And there's a good opportunity that just went awry there. A drop pass. I guess that's why they call them running backs and not catching backs.
Hurry up, here we go. Boom, landed.
They'll look to throw. He's got time in the pocket. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense. But when you add to it that you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit, hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the fourth quarter, Got to feel pretty good as a defense.
He's going to... Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Carr going to look to throw. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. But he will not be able to bring it back. My goodness, what a bizarre ending. The kind of decision that could get a quarterback released before he gets back to the locker room. But fortunately for him and his crew, the ball game is over. And Charles, when you pull out a close game, the good thing about that is maybe next time you're in a nail biter in the fourth quarter, you have a little more confidence.
Yeah, you're talking about your memory muscles, right? When you win those close ones, you have that confident feeling that you can continue to do so every time you're in that position.
Now that said, you would rather win by 60 points, or do you like the close ones too?
Well, I think everyone would rather win by 60. It's comfortable, everyone gets to play. But when you win those nail biters, dinner tastes just a little bit better that day.